There's only one place to be, and that's WCW Monday Nitro. It has set the precedent. It has set the standard. It has been the flag waver for this sport. And it's live, and the only live weekly program each and every Monday, 8 o'clock Eastern Time. Not one, but two solid hours of Nitro. The team of Rough and Ready, Mike Enos and Dirty Dick Slater, to go up against Joe Gomez and Todd Morton.
I tell you what, this is a good-looking bunch right here. I'm going to tell you something about Mike Enos. He's a mean one.
Yes, he is.
Why do every time I start talking, I know Greg is going to get on me about this, but Dave tends to start talking. I mean, he can hear me when I'm starting a soliloquy, when I start talking about somebody and everything, and you just go right on through it. You just talk right on and over.
See, you got to adjust yourself here.
Yeah.
And keep it. It's like you said.
He's like a net.
Well,
you know what? He's like you do the net.
It is like you said, you got to keep going at the beginning of the program.
Well, as I said, Mike Enos is a real mean one, along with Dick Slater. I'm going to tell you what, Connor Parker really got him a pair of rough and ready guys right here, taking care of some business now with young Joe Gomez.
Joe Gomez, right hand. And look at this action. Ooh, arm drag takedown. You know, of all that's gone down, when we talked about Hulk Hogan, the man, what he has meant to the sport, he has been out in Hollywood on making a movie, I understand. And we do understand that coming up this coming Tuesday, the 16th of July,
spit it out,
that TBS will be airing the broadcast premiere of Mr. Nanny, starring none other than Hulk Hogan. Hollywood Hulk Hogan is what the Macho Man called him.
Yeah, and that was a good choice of words right there. Wow.
The nanny.
Mr. Nanny. Well, we're going to see Mr. Nanny, Hollywood Hulk Hogan, this Tuesday on WCW on TBS. It's at 8:05 Eastern Time. I've just been handed this note.
Yeah, I told.
We're going to see him Monday on Nitro.
Yeah. Hulk Hogan, the one we know.
The one we know
the
now.
The one that shocked the world and what happened. That changed the course of history at WCW. And Dick Slater, rough and ready all the time. Stomping a mud hole in you right out here. Mike Enos, Dick Slater, Connor Parker got him a pair to draw to. You know what I'm talking about? And I wouldn't put them bringing plunder out either. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
I mean, these two guys can do it. This Mike Enos, he got a lot of talent. And he's got that mean streak. Oh!
Todd Morton sent to the top rope by Mike Enos. I'll tell you, Mike Enos absorbed a lot of punishment that time, and he kept right on coming, and that's why the nickname Rough and Ready, and that's exactly what they are. Colonel Parker,
look at this,
has a couple of great tag teams. Won the champs, and of course, this team of Rough and Ready. Of course, remember, if Colonel Parker loses focus like he did, he could have some problems on his hands.
Yeah, but I think these two guys right here would take care of business.
Whoa!
Look at them elbows across the nose. Bridge of the face.
Dick Slater holding up Todd Morton with elbows across the nose, like you said, Dream. And Todd trying to get away, but he's right in their corner. Here's a pickup and a belly to mat. We will show you the footage from WCW's Bash of the Beach later on in this telecast. Stay with us. And there's a clothesline. A lateral press. One, and he pulled him up by the hair, Dream.
Well, he's got that mean streak in him. Very simply, he knows he's on Saturday night, the mothership trying to make a statement in the world of tag team wrestling at WCW. Todd Martin trying to fight back. But Dick Slater going to come in and call this thing off. Boom.
The youngster, Todd Morton, got a lot of fight in him, and there's no denying that, but he is being overwhelmed here. Randy Eller trying to prevent the double team, but it's not going to happen here. The big cowboy boots right to the head of Todd Morton. And certainly Todd desperately needs a tag. Don't forget, we also have Public Enemy and Colonel Parker's other duo of Harlem Heat coming in. Our slam, one, two, three. Rough and Ready with a win. Look at the face on Enos, would you? Is this man ready or what?
Yeah. He looks like something's wrong with him all the time.
Enos and Slater, they are quite a duo. For Colonel Rob Parker and your winners here on WCW Saturday Night, where the big boys play. Do you understand, Hulk Hogan? This is where the big boys play. As Colonel Parker finishes his victory talk.
Oh, yeah.
You can pick us up here anytime.
Yeah, and I know I'm just watching Parker because...
Like I'm handing a football off to Emmitt Smith and he doesn't catch it.
Yeah, but listen.
Go ahead.
Would you stop that? But listen to this. I was thinking about Harlem Heat and the situation here with these two guys right here. If Parker wanted to put together some really... Anonymous, you know what I mean? That doesn't do 400 types of situation. He's got some artillery. Rough and ready, got a victory right here on Saturday night all the way to the bay window.
And they're making their way over to Mean Gene Okerlund.
I'm joined right now by Rough and Ready, along with Colonel Robert Parker, a man who, as I understand it, holds a lot of paper on land here in Florida. But Colonel Parker, the thing I'm curious about, what about this cane?
You know... That there cane was given to me by my good friend, rock and roll singer, Tom Petty. He knows I have a bout of gout in my feet from time to time.
You shouldn't eat so much shellfish.
You know, don't try to be funny out here. You know, it's a funny thing, but it seems like a lot of the friends of the opponents of both the Rough and Ready and the Harlem Heat are quoting Tom Petty. They're all looking at the opponent saying, hey, boy, you look like somebody kicked you around some.
That's what Tom Petty, the race car driver, right?
Oh, Tom Petty, race car driver. You know, we got an interesting event coming up here, Gene.
Yes, indeed. And I'd like to know, you've got Rough and Ready, but you're also tied into the Harlem Heat. Now, how can you manage both without a conflict of interest?
You know, that's that right there. I'm a promoter. There comes the manager right there.
Goodness. Jerry and the Harlem Heat.
Hey, wait a minute, Colonel. We hired you to promote us. No managing, if you know what I mean. And I don't know what the deal is on these two Rexall drugstore cowboys. What's up?
Let me tell you something, Gene. We ain't worried about these two rednecks, and we ain't worried about nobody, because we are the World Tag Team Champions, and Carol is going to stay that way, man.
And no head, you just keep your mouth shut before somebody slaps it off.
Later, please, reserve that for the ring. Sherry, all of a sudden, you're involved again, but what's going on here? Is this
Back
a romance?
Off.
Wait a minute. This is the woman that left you on the altar. Now, you know what I'm saying? This woman left you.
Back off! Let me tell you something. I didn't leave anybody at the altar. As a matter of fact, you are the one that was two-timing me with Rod Powell. Now, I want to know what the issue is. Where do you stand? Back off, Slater!
Listen, I'll tell you where I said. Listen, y'all go into the shower there, boys.
Go on, take
that.
That
wasn't nothing.
What was that?
That wasn't nothing.
Wait a minute now.
I'm not winking. I got something in my eye out here.
Colonel, I think you've dug yourself a bit of a hole. We're going to have to try sort this out as we go to break. Stay tuned. More Saturday Night here on TBS.